Good morning once again. I am Katarina and from University of Ljubljana, Faculty of Health Sciences, Occupational Therapy Department. I am assistant and PhD student, and I work with older people for 15 years. And my purpose today is to talk about living conditions and independence of elderly in home environment. In developed countries, most people in their 60s and 70s are still fit, active, and able to care for themselves. However, after 75, they will become increasingly frail, a condition marked by serious mental and physical conditions. Gerontologists have recognized diversity of old age by defining subgroups. Delineating subgroups in the 65 population enables a more accurate and portrayal of significant life changing. Across the European Union member states, the highest share of persons aged 65 plus in total population in 2014 was observed in Italy and in Germany. In Italy was 29% and in Germany was 21%. Ireland has the lowest proportion with 12%. Slovenia is somewhere in the middle, as we can see, with 17%. Indicators of elderly health are activities of daily living, medical history, mental status, perception, social participation, environment, economy, and institution. Activities of daily living and environment are the main subject of my research. Of older people 65 plus live in different institutions like nursing homes, homes for elderly. And active aging depends on partnership between individuals, communities, and government. It requires individuals to take some responsibility for health, lifestyle, but also requires the provision of age-friendly built environment, opportunity for social and economic participation, and culturally appropriate services that meet different and changing levels of need. As I mentioned before, I'm an occupational therapist. The process I use is assessment, intervention, and evaluation, the outcomes. When I work, I am focused on identifying and eliminating environmental barriers to independence and participation in daily activities. Occupational therapy is a client-centered practice. Occupational therapy intervention focused on adapting the environment, modifying tasks, teaching skills, educating the client and family to increase participation and performance of daily activities, particularly those that are meaning to the client. Environmental factors are part of international classification of function model. I assist at home environment different factors and try to advise elderly appropriate and affordable solution for transforming environment. Another model is Canadian model of occupational performance and engagement. This model was developed by the Canadian Association of Occupational Therapists in 1997. Model illustrated relationship between person, occupation, and environment. Spirituality is four dimension placed in the center of the model to highlight its fundamental importance. The next model is person-environment-occupational performance model. This is client-centered model is and is used to improve the performance of individuals in their daily lives. Model talks about the personal factors and environmental factors that support, enable, or restrict the performance of individual to their activity, task, and rules that are present in their lives. The aim of this study was to assess the level of independence in activities of daily living and instrumental activities of daily living, and also to analyze environmental factors influencing the level of independence. We formulated four hypotheses. Hypothesis one, we are assuming that independence of the elderly in activity of daily living and instrumental activity of daily living varies according to gender. Hypothesis two, we are assuming that independence of the elderly in activity of daily living and instrumental activity of daily living varies according to age. Hypothesis three, we are assuming that independence of the elderly in ADL and EIDL varies according to who they are living with. And the hypothesis four, we are assuming that older people who are living in appropriate adapted environment are more independent. The study sample involves 450 participants, 68 plus, living in home environments. We divided the sample into two groups. One group is age between 65 and 80, and the other group is 80 plus. We identified the level of independence of study participants in daily activities with two assessments. The first one is activities of daily living, and the other one is instrumental activities of daily living. And we also list the check questionnaire about environmental factors. The first and second questionnaires are formed in three-level scale, where one mean completely dependent on assistant, two mean semi-dependent on assistant, and three mean independent. These are activity of daily living, bathing, dressing, feeding, grooming, transferring from bed to chair, and moving around inside the house. Here are the list of instrumental activities of daily living, which are using telephone, getting distance, walking, shopping, preparing meal, doing housework, performing laundry, managing medications and finances. And in environmental checklist, this is list of environmental factor and was used to determine the environmental factors representing potential injury hazards. Checklist offering three possible answers: yes, no, and not present. With checklist, we are checked floors, furniture, light, bathroom, storage, stairways, steps, and mobility. And here are our results. 70% of our study samples comprised women. Participants was aged between 65 and 94, and the average age was 75 years. Here we can see that statistically significant gender-based differences in three ADL. This was feeding, dressing, and appearance. And also we can see that men need more assistance than a woman. The next results are showed significant gender-based differences in five EADL activities. These are using phone, mobility, preparing meal, meals, doing housework and manage medication. And here also, men need more assistance than a woman. Exception is mobility. Also here we can see that this showed a statistically significant independence in 5 ideal activities: feeding, dressing, appearance, walking, and bathing. And level of independence in the group 2 is required more assistance than 1. It's quite normal because group 2 is older. And the next, we can see statistically significant differences in 7 ideal activities, and also group 2 need more assistance than those from group 1. All listed ideal activities are statistically significant, but ideal activities are not statistically significant. The elderly who live alone are more independent in using phone, preparing meals, and doing housework. The older who live with spouse are more independent with mobility, shopping, managing medication, and money. But the elderly living with their immediate family, they are statistically less independent in those who living with their spouse or alone. Okay. With the last C-square test was used to test the correlation between the level of independence and obstacles in home environment. We present here just some of pairs, ADL and EADL variables, and environmental factors, which contextual correlation that showed statistically significant difference with respect to difficulties in performing activities in the early home environment. And for conclusion, so let me just go our key points again. We can partly confirm hypothesis 1, 2, and 3 because we don't have the statistically significant for all activities, just at hypothesis 1, 3 of ADL and 5 of EADL, with hypothesis 2, 5 of ADL and 7 of EADL, and in hypothesis 3, only 7 of EADL and no activities of ADL. Hypothesis 4 we confirmed completely. And how we'll look our research in future? We think we need to extend the pattern to the population aged over 60 plus, and also to include more health indicators. That's, and thank you.